Hi, I'm Mathroberg, and today we're going to learn about direct and inverse variation. Let's start with an example of direct variation. Now, slices of bread and the number of sandwiches you can make are directly related if we assume that it takes two pieces of bread or two slices of bread to make a sandwich. Let's give these two variables names. Let's call the number of slices of bread you have x, and the number of sandwiches you can make, y. And let's make an xy table. So if I had 20 slices of bread, how many sandwiches could I make with that? Well, each sandwich requires two slices of bread, so I could make 10 sandwiches before I used up all 20 slices of bread. What if I had only 8 slices of bread? Well, then I could make 4 sandwiches. What if I add 100 slices of bread? Well, then I could make 50 sandwiches. If we summarize the relationship between our variable x, slices of bread, and y, number of sandwiches, we could use the equation, the number of sandwiches we can make equals half the amount, or this number of slices of bread we have. Y equals 1/2 x. This 1/2 we call the constant of variation. X and y can vary. The slices of bread and the number of sandwiches we can make can vary, like it did in this table. But the one thing that remains the same is this 1/2, the constant of variation. In general, direct variation can be modeled with the following formula. Y equals ax, where a is the constant of variation. Now let's look at an example of inverse variation. Let me tell you about my friend Johnny. Now Johnny's a very strong guy. In fact, he's so strong, he can run with someone on his back. So someone can grab onto him and he can run. Now he doesn't run as fast as if no one was on his back, but it's still pretty impressive that he can move at all. Now here, we have the number of people on Johnny's back and the speed Johnny can run in miles per hour. If we let x be the number of people on Johnny's back, and y be the speed Johnny can run in miles per hour, we can model this relationship inversely using this formula. Y equals 12 over x. So let's look at a few examples. What if there was one person on Johnny's back? Well, here we have x is 1, so 12 divided by 1 is 12. What if there was two people on Johnny's back? 12 divided by 2 is 6. What if Johnny had 4 people on his back? 12 divided by 4 equals 3. So with 4 people on Johnny's back, he can still run 3 miles per hour. In general, inverse variation can be modeled like this. Y equals A divided by X, where our constant of variation is A. What's our constant of variation in our actual example? Well, in this case, it was 12. There's one key difference between direct and inverse variation. With direct variation, as one variable increases, the other one does as well. So as x increases, y increases. Inverse variation has the opposite effect. As one variable increases, the other variable decreases. So let's look at our two examples again. In direct variation, as we increase the number of slices of bread, the number of sandwiches we could make increase. In our example with Johnny, as we increase the number of people on Johnny's back, the speed Johnny could run decreased. Let's see if we can look at these equations and figure out if the variables are directly or inversely related. Let's also see if we can find the constant of variation. Now in this first example, y equals 3x, we see that this is in form y equals ax. So this is direct variation. And our constant of variation is the a, in this case, 3. In our second example here, we see that y equals 4 divided by x. This is in the form y equals a over x. We call this inverse variation. And our constant of variation, a, is 4. Finally, we have y equals 1/2 x. Now actually, this example, example 1, and example 3, are in the same form, y equals ax. So this is, again, direct variation. And our constant of variation, a, is 1/2. Now let's try these examples, 1, 2, and 3. We're trying to find, is it direct or inverse variation? And what is the constant of variation? Well, let's see, we know direct variation will be in the form y equals ax. And we know inverse variation will be in the form y equals a over x. So let's see if we can put these three equations into one of those two forms. Go for it. This first one, if we divide both sides by x, we're left with y equals 7 over x. We can clearly see now that y equals 7 over x is in the form y equals a over x. So this is inverse variation. And our constant of variation is 7. In the second problem, let's multiply both sides by 4 to solve for y. By doing that, we see that this is direct variation because it's in the form y equals ax, where a is 4. Now the last example, y equals x plus 3, is already solved for y. And we see there's really nothing we could do to get it into direct or inverse variation form. So in this case, it's neither direct or inverse variation. So it's neither direct nor inverse variation. So there's no constant variation to talk about. Here's an interesting example. We're told that x and y vary inversely, and y equals 7 when x equals 4. Our task is to write an equation that relates x and y. Then they want us to find y when x equals negative 2. Luckily, we have a huge hint. We know that x and y vary inversely. As soon as I see that word inversely, I know that this equation I'm going to have to write has the form y equals a over x. This is the general form of an inverse variation equation. So now let's use the other information we have. We're told that y equals 7 when x equals 4. Let's see. If we go back to our equation here and we plug in a 7 for y, we know that 7 has to equal a divided by our x, 4. So in order for this equation to be true, what would our constant of variation have to be? Well, let's see. Let's solve for a. If I multiply both sides by 4, we'd end up with 28 on this side and just a on this side. So we just found our constant of variation. Our constant of variation, a, is 28. That means our equation that relates x and y is simply y equals 28 divided by x. This is our inverse variation equation that relates x and y. Now let's find out what y would be when x equals negative 2. So we need to find y when x equals negative 2. Let's use our newly found equation here. Y will equal 28 divided by whatever our x is. And it looks like our x is negative 2. So 28 divided by negative 2 is negative 14.